Twitch finally released their channel analytics page, and in this video, we're gonna go over how the analytics can help you grow and understand your channel to take it to the next level. Coming at you right now. Hey, it's me, it's Wild, coming at you for my stream support playlist where I bring you the best tips and tricks and even a little bit of education. Just like in this video right here, if this is your first time here, consider subscribing and helping a bro out by ticking that bell so you know when my videos go live. Twitch released not too long ago their channel analytics, and it shows a lot of interesting things from revenue to who's watching you. And a lot of these stats and analytics can help all of us grow and understand our channel. So let's take a look at what they revealed to a lot of the users out there and how it can help us grow all together. Let's go over to the desktop. Once you're logged into your page, make sure you go to your dashboard. If you're not sure how to get to it, go to the top right corner and click on the arrow and you'll see it right here. Click on dashboard. It's going to load all the necessary information for you, but we want to be concerned with the left ledger. If you notice over here, we've got a new analytics left ledger, but all we're concerned about is channel. Go ahead and tick on that, and it's going to load all of our information. As you can see, it's got this beautiful new layout and it shows all the months up here. You can click forward and back. So here you can see that we have March, and we can continue to keep going back to February and January and so forth. But let's go back to April, since that's the month that we're in. And here it displays all of the information that you have. You got your average viewers, you got your live views, new followers, subscriptions, and revenue. And of course, you can sort these by what you want to show in the graph below. And you can resort this by day, week, or month. Now, this is all very interesting, especially for things like average viewer count, if you're trying to become an affiliate or a partner, or how many live views or new followers you're getting, so that way you can see if you're having higher highs and lower lows, so that way you know you're growing on either a viewer base or a subscription base. But you can all take a look at your own revenue. We're not really talking about how to make money or what that's showing, but the most important analytic that I want to show you is actually at the bottom of the page. If we scroll all the way down, you'll see a few cool things down here. You have your top five videos of where you've had your most views over here to the right, and you can sort these by new followers, new subscriptions. That way you can see what games are actually driving growth to your channel, or perhaps which categories are driving new subs or new followers, or what is bringing higher retentions of people that are watching you. You also have your top clips for this given month that'll be displayed right here. If you want to see any more, you can click on view details, but it also shows you what it was from and who clipped it for you, which is kind of nice. And you can grab these if you want to post them to your social media. But the most important thing that we have is actually this bottom left corner down here. Where did my views come from? And it shows you that I had 671 views, and it's shown me broken down where these people came from. Most of these people were followers, about 70%. The rest came from Twitch's browser page, and 3% came from other. Then it shows you what channels were driven to me to get higher viewership for my channel itself. Essentially, this is basically saying who is rating my channel and who is hosting my channel, whether it be a actual typed in host or an auto host. And then here's all the external views that I get. As you can see, it's direct from Twitch is the highest one, then local, and then the Discord. I don't really use Discord, so mine will always be low. And if we click on view details, Twitch actually breaks this down into stronger categories here. You can actually view by location. As you can see, most of my views, the top three, United States, Canada, Australia. And then you can see where the views are coming from on Twitch. Well, it's coming from my followers, my browser page, other sources, my channel direct, people from email notifications and things like that as it goes down, and all the way down to search, which is pretty cool. If anybody's ever searching for you, it'd be interesting to know. As well as what we said before with people that would be hosting or rating you would be displayed over here on the right hand side. This is always fascinating to me because you can see who is helping you the most, so that way you can give them some good thanks and kudos, because all these things these people do, they deserve accolades for helping my channel grow. The most important one that I would think that's gonna help people pay off for their analytics and their statistics is this bottom one right here. View by platform. This is one of my favorite stats, and I think a lot of people forget how people watch them on Twitch. If you take a look at your analytics and you look at the stats of who's watching you from what platform, you'd be surprised at how many mobile people are watching you. If you think of mobile, they're only watching you on a few inches of screen. And one of the most important things is making sure that your stream's landscape retail space is being utilized correctly. A lot of people like to have things like memes or GIFs or overlays or tickers or donation counters or stream counters, sub counters, things that go up, things that go down, chat lists that go left and right and pop-ups and everything. And those are all fine and great, but consider the size of them when you're putting them on your broadcasting software. Remember, a lot of people are only watching on this much space, so they're not gonna be able to maybe read a lot of the names or the donations or what's going on, or if you're supporting a charity, because it's so super tiny at the bottom for their screen. Take in consideration your layout of your stream, because you might be surprised that probably about a third to 50% might be watching you on mobile. If we continue to scroll all the way to the bottom, the last analytic that we get from Twitch is views from outside of Twitch. As we can see, this doesn't give us much information other than direct and localhost. Pretty much everything comes directly from Twitch. But I do find it kind of fascinating, if you are a Discord person, of how many people would be driven from Discord and also YouTube. It'd be nice if they had a few more outside sources that were reaching in that they could read, perhaps something like a Reddit, how many people are being directed from, maybe people are posting your clips on Reddit that are getting directed to your channel. That would be something interesting to find, or Google itself. There'd be a lot of other platforms I'd like to see under here, so that way I know if my social media, for instance, if I'm posting I Go Live on Twitter, it'd be nice to know how much of that actual click-through rate is coming through off of that, so that way I know which to concentrate on, if I need to concentrate more on Instagram or Twitter. It'd be nice to have a little more deeper breath on these analytics. But to begin with, you know, this is actually very clean and nice, and hopefully it'll help a lot of you out there understand how your channel is growing, where your revenue is coming from, how people are watching you, where they're watching you from. These are all very strong details that you need to know to take your stream to the next level. Well, hopefully that gives you a better understanding of how Twitch analytics works for you and your channel. It's not as in-depth as the YouTube analytics page, but hey, it's a start. At least it lets us know a few key factors out there that'll allow us to understand what's going on within our channel, and also give us a better understanding at the revenue we are getting from Twitch itself. Hey, if you guys like this video, go ahead and give it a nice thumbs up, and make sure to leave a comment below and help a bro out by following him on all his social medias. And you can watch me paint live on Twitch all the time during the week. If you guys want to see more videos like this, make sure you let me know. And if you want to help support, make sure to go above and beyond and support me on my Patreon page. I will see you guys all in the next stream support playlist coming at you real soon. Take care. Peace.